Hello everyone, welcome to Tech and Travel. Today we have with us the AirTag. In this video, we're going to test out two things. One, the accuracy of AirTags, and two, the range of AirTags under different conditions, both indoor and outdoor. So let's get into it, and we'll obviously come to the verdict eventually to help you decide if this is the right buy for you. Now let's look at how precise this is. I'm going to take it right next, and it says here. Let me start moving it a bit and bring it a little bit away, and it says 0.3 meters. And let's do this. Let's just look at how far it really is. It's actually about 34 centimeters away. That is very precise. So now, what if I bring it closer here? Obviously it says 0.3 for some time. Now it turns to 0.2. Let me bring it closer. It becomes 0.1. It's about 10 centimeters. And really, and guys, this is like literally 10 centimeters, or yeah, this distance is from edge to edge about 11 centimeters. It says 0.1 meter away. It is super precise. We're talking about less than 4 inches here. Let's take it closer, a bit closer here. That's where you go. So the moment you get from this edge, the moment you are about, you know, within 10 centimeters, it says here. Now let's look at how does it behave over longer distances. Yeah, I made it now 0.5. Is it 50 meters, 50 centimeters away? It is approximately 45, 50 centimeters there. So you can say that from this experiment, it's pretty clear that AirTags are very precise. They do have precision of plus or minus 10 centimeters. It's within 10 centimeters. Which is within plus or minus 4 inches. And it's important to understand that this precision comes from the UN chip and the ultra wide band. In short, tile that doesn't have the UN chip will simply not give you this precision. So let's get started with the range test. For short distances, AirTags depend on ultra wide band and Bluetooth LE. And we're going to test out this in detail. We'll also test out if AirTags really can work anywhere, leveraging the 1 billion Apple devices network worldwide. So firstly, let's look at the long range test. In this specific scenario, our AirTags were about 150 meters away from where we were. This was detected through the Apple's 1 billion devices network. Essentially, someone would have passed close to our AirTags while we were about 200 meters away. Our Apple Maps took us right there. We took the directions from the Apple Maps, kept walking all the way, and eventually we were there where our AirTags were. So to summarize, this test went pretty well. And as soon as we got close to the AirTags, we could shift to the near mode and exactly figure out where our AirTags were. Next, we experimented with AirTags in the open air with absolutely no obstructions whatsoever. So we started from zero and we kept walking away from the AirTags, and we tested it out to its extreme. So as you can see, now we have exceeded 25 meters. We're about 28 meters away. And let's try a bit more. And I guess at this 28 meters range, this is when we got this message, which says that, well, it is connected, but the signal is not as strong, and I guess this is the upper limit of the ultra wide band range. Next, we did the same experiment again, but this time standing further away from the AirTag. So while we were more than 20 meters away, it kept saying that it's out of range. At 25 meters, it was the very first time it could detect the signal, although it kept fluctuating between weak signal and strong signal. The moment we started walking towards, and as soon as we touched about 20 meters, that's when we could get the exact signal. And the good news is the screen turns green as soon as you have strong signal. And as you can see, yeah, the moment we were less than 16 meters, we could get the direction there, and it was fully green less than 10 meters all the way to exactly where our AirTags were. So yeah, these were ideal conditions
outdoor without any hindrances whatsoever, and AirTags did have a range of 25 meters. A similar test done indoor also gave a similar range. Obviously, we could get more than 20 meters indoors as well, as long as we were fully direct. Next, we moved to our fourth test, and we tested out if AirTags would have any influence or obstruction from a glass door. And guess what? That also worked out pretty well. It was at least 15 meters. My guess is it would be very similar to 20 meters that you would find otherwise indoor. Now let's make the test tougher. Our fifth test was testing out if AirTags could work across a soft wall. Not a concrete wall, but a soft wall. We tested it out, and to our surprise, it worked just as fine. A soft wall didn't really stop the signals, and we could still get a range of about 15 meters. Now on to our sixth test. We made things a bit tougher. We placed our AirTags in our wardrobes and in drawers, and we tested it to about 3 layers of wood. And to our surprise, it worked fairly well even across 3 layers of wood. Obviously, the range reduced a little bit. It went to about 6 meters, 20 feet. But having said that, it still is pretty useful, because this is the typical use case. You would most likely lose your keys in the wardrobe. Similarly, we tested it across a concrete wall, and there, yet again, the range dropped a bit. Here it was down to 3 meters. So really, if you're across a concrete wall, then the range drops substantially. And our last test, we tested it against a concrete structural wall, which is really thick. And that's where it started to give some issues. I'm not sure the signals went through entirely. At one point, we could sense it at about 1 meter away. But yeah, I mean, that's asking for too much.
So now, let's come to the overall verdict from all the tests that we have run. So, firstly, accuracy. As far as distance and direction is concerned, it is extremely accurate. It is down to within 10 centimeters in our test. It could be as low as 5 centimeters, but it doesn't really matter. You know, the length of your phone is much more than 10 centimeters, and therefore this is extremely accurate. So I would give it full marks on accuracy. Now, two, the range of ultra-wide band technology. The range of ultra-wide band is sort of similar to Wi-Fi in some ways. It works well within 25 meters, up to 80 feet, give or take a few, as long as there is nothing in between. But what is very important to understand is that it doesn't have a range of 200 meters or 0.1 mile, right? That's not the range that we're looking at. We're looking at Wi-Fi equivalent ranges in the order of 25, 30 meters, 80 to 100 feet at best. Now, next comes the worldwide iCloud range, and this works fantastically well as long as you have iOS devices next to you. So in summary there, it will work well within cities. It works just as FindMy people or FindMy device works on the iPhone. Lastly, the price. I think at $29, Apple has been extremely competitive when it comes to price. So overall, our verdict is very simple. If you are an iPhone user and you have the habit like I do of misplacing your wallet and keys and whatnot, then don't think twice. Simply just go ahead and get an AirTag.
For more such unbiased reviews and for the latest on tech and travel, subscribe to our channel, Tech and Travel.